I'm sitting on a book and a pillow because I'm short AF.
I can't believe it.
She was like, what are you sitting on a book for? I'm like, because I'm 5'3". Sometimes people say we look alike.
Hey girl, hi.
You see the resemblance?
I think it.
Twinning.
You know what's funny? I don't even have that wrong.
She is, if you don't already know, you're living under a rock. This is Natasha Hastings.
I'm a sprinter for Team USA. I don't know, this stuff makes me blush.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
She won, like, medals, you know, the things you wear around your neck.
Yeah, so I have, like, two of those things that you win at the Olympics. Like, you know, just two gold medals.
MVP.
And then a few medals from World Championships.
She slipped into my DMs, and I about fainted in the middle of the street when I got it. I had just submitted a proposal that was like, who's on your like dream cast list for this video I'm trying to do, which you guys will see soon. And she's in it. And then next thing I know, she's sending my DMs. Was like, what's up, girl? You want to do a collab?
Always down to like meet up with boss chicks. Like, I'm all about female empowerment and women that are out here doing their thing. So I was like, why not? I'm coming home. If you got some time, let's make it happen.
I need you to teach me how to wear a red lipstick.
Your red lipstick war paint. Yes, yes, yes.
I'll put a link in the description so you guys know what we're referring to.
Okay.
Haven't yet seen it. We work with Under Armour, and Under Armour made this amazing. Who is your poet?
Dominique Christina. She was insane.
Freaking amazing. They had these poets align with the athletes and write a poem about them, and it's set to this like really beautiful footage. So that's where this picture's from. And it's the whole red lipstick war paint warrior. It's freaking amazing.
It was insane. It gave me goosebumps. That's why, you know, we're here. Under Armour does their thing to empower women, empower the female athlete. So
yeah. And I raise money on Patreon through this channel for Girls Inc. And Under Armour matched my donation.
Oh,
so
really?
It's been awesome. 6 months. We've raised $4,000, and this is like an ongoing thing. So I know we can do more, guys. $4,000 is just the beginning, but we funded a whole field trip, and next thing we're gonna fund a sports camp.
Ooh,
so
see?
On that, if you have
out here empowering girls. Yes.
Yes. To empower us further, I wanted to get, that's what this whole video is about, right? It's really selfish. I want to learn how to get fancy.
I hope I can help.
I wanted to know 5 things I can do to start getting faster today. I mean, I've got my off season. It's my off season right now, so
same.
I've got months to practice the things you're going to tell me. And this is for everyone who's watching too. So for those of us who like are not natural sprinters, it's helpful to know just like an insight into how you guys train so that we can see like how we can get better at sprinting and speed.
First and foremost, I think the thing that we talk about when we're talking about getting fast is number one, developing those fast twitch muscles. Some of us have more or less than others. We all have them, and that is ultimately the thing that you want to develop when you're talking about. The art then becomes the balance in the training, in that you don't want to lose the strength, obviously. You gotta build the speed. For me particularly, I know that it kind of works reverse for me. When I say like, and by reverse, I mean in the off season, I'm doing more strength stuff. And then when we move closer to in season and in competition, that's when we're doing more speed.
Yeah.
By that, we're doing shorter distances, of course, and they're more percentage exertion is a little bit faster. Well, not a little bit, a bit faster. So for me, as a sprinter, my idea of sprint work is 30 meters, 20 meters, 40 meters, and it's like just getting out and just balls to the wall. Another thing is kind of tricking yourself to get the speed and the volume in at the same time. So my coach knows that I hate volume. What he will do is give me shorter distances, but he cuts the rest so that I'm getting the volume in, i.e. if it's say a broken 300. So by that, I'll have a 100, rest 30 seconds, another 100, rest 30 seconds. I'm getting 300 meters in, which is kind of more like speed endurance, but I'm also getting the speed work in at the same time. So I'm kind of getting the volume, but I'm also keeping the speed tempo up.
It's funny when you say volume and you're talking about 300 meters, centuries, 100 miles.
Yeah.
It's so different.
That conversation, like I very rarely currently, like in the off season, the overall volume of my workout, I might get up to a mile and a half.
That's amazing.
But like when I'm like intense training, the most we'll get up to is like 1,000 meters.
So the longest you will run is a mile and a half.
And let me take that back. In my off season, like now, where I'm like totally not training, I'll put my headphones on and go for like a 15-20 minute run.
Oh, okay.
So,
but that's like for fun.
It's kind of for fun, kind of. I don't want to get all the way out of shape, kind of thing. But I don't know exactly how far I'm running. I would like to think that I'm running about 2 miles. If I know how far I'm going, having a sprinter's mindset, I'm never gonna make it. I have to trick myself into running volume. I'm telling you, I hate volume.
So how do you trick yourself? Like your best favorite music?
Exactly.
Okay.
Favorite music, turn on a timer and just go.
Yeah, music for sure. Do you ever run to podcasts? Probably not.
No. I need like upbeat, like get me pumped, almost get me mad.
Yeah.
Kind of music.
If I'm doing a sprint workout, I have to be kind of pissed off or like in that like really aggro like steroid zone.
No, true story.
It's the only way I'm gonna get it done. I hate sprinting, so it's like a mind game for me every time I have to do it.
I won't say that I hate sprinting, but it's actually difficult for me in the sense of, even though I'm a sprinter, I'm a long sprinter. So I'm more a 150, 250 girl. Mm-hmm. So when I do the 30 meters and the 60 meters, in the moment, I'm fine. It is tapping another energy system that I'm not used to using all the time. But where the challenge becomes is the next day, that onset soreness. The workout is fine, but I go home and I'm like, oh shoot, I actually put some work in today.
Yeah.
So then that becomes the challenge of, you know, you kind of, which is what training is, you put yourself into a deficit to come back up. So then the challenge becomes the next day, you can't take the day off. You know, you still have to train and, you know, hopefully work towards whatever it is that you're working. So how do you balance that?
So, do you ever do 2 sprint workouts back to back, like 2 days in a row, or you wouldn't do that?
It depends on the phase of training that we're in. I will say that my coach typically, we kind of have an on-off system. Mondays would be our high volume day, and by that I mean like maybe 500s. And then Tuesday would be a speed day, speed endurance day. So we'll do like some 100s, some 80s. And then Wednesday, we'll go back up in volume. Thursday, so you kind of give each energy system time to rest and recover before you tax that system again. That kind of helps with getting faster too, is knowing how to give each system a break, but tax them all.
Yeah, so that's another question I have then about resting. Like if you're working with numbers, you're trying to get faster. Let's say you're trying to beat, you're trying to PR or something, and you go for your attempt. How many days would you rest until you try again? I don't give myself enough rest.
Right.
And when I started resting more, I was more successful.
And when you don't give yourself enough rest and you don't hit it, is it more of a mental challenge than a physical challenge? Because that's the other thing too that I think is left out.
No.
We're kind of in this culture where everyone wants to just train, and it's like, no, you actually have to give your body enough time to recover, and you're actually doing more detriment by not doing that, not just physically, but mentally. Because if you go in there and you set a goal and you don't hit it how many times, eventually you're gonna beat yourself down mentally and physically. So typically a week, I would take between, like say if we had a time trial and it didn't go as planned or coach feels like, you know, I can do it again, it would typically be a week, and that's to kind of mimic sometimes maybe a competition cycle.
Yeah.
Or just again, to give myself enough time to physically rebound and mentally rebound, because it is something that you have to go into and have the mindset that, hey, this is what I'm gonna do, but also you have to be physically in that space.
Before you go into like a sprint workout, do you fuel up with, do you caffeinate? Do you do pre-workout?
I'm a coffee girl, so by the time, and I probably shouldn't say this, but it's the truth. I do pre-workouts, but I do like beta-alanine.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I make sure whatever supplements I take, I make sure that they're cleared by USADA and WADA. But I usually do a beta-alanine and I'm a cup of coffee a day girl anyway, so I always have a cup of coffee, and sometimes I will time it to be right before a workout. I found that it especially works for sprint workouts too. 30 minutes
right before.
Before. Mm-hmm.
30 minutes before my race, I will chug a Red Bull. I mean, there are usually a lot of Red Bull around.
Yeah.
So
I actually do 5-hour energies before, and this isn't a sponsored video.
No, it's not.
Yeah, but I do 5-hour energies about 30
minutes. That stuff makes me feel cracked out. But
really? I think I find that the crash afterwards isn't as bad as with the Red Bull.
Oh, maybe because Red Bull has sugar, more sugar.
Yeah.
5-hour energy has more caffeine, though, I think. So it's like, maybe I'll try it. I'll try one. See how it goes. You mentioned in your off season you do a lift, you do a lot of strength workout in the gym.
Yeah.
What's your structure of your workout? Are you doing plyometrics? Or are you doing like a combo?
Combo. Okay. So we do lots of plyo, and I'm glad you asked that because that does have a part to play in
the speed
work. And we try to mimic the things that we're doing out there on the track. So the idea is everything that I'm doing in the gym supports what I'm doing on the track. I do squats, I do power cleans, deadlifts, but everything is fast. Everything is, again, intended to develop those fast twitch muscles.
Uh-huh.
So we're doing the fast power cleans, we're doing the triple extension, the squats. Well, I would say mostly jumps and squats, and of course, it's a full body thing, but when you talk about speed development, those are the core exercises that I would say we include.
Got it.
And then the other thing too is when you do those things, you want to pair it with a sprint workout.
Yeah.
Because again, everything goes.
So same day? Really?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I never do that.
No.
Maybe that's what I need to do. Oh, that sounds barf worthy. Are you kidding?
It's not, honestly, the barf thing comes more when I say when like, either I didn't eat, what's the word, I didn't give my food enough time to digest before I work out, or I've gone through a barrier. When that does happen, in my mind, I'm like, okay, the next time I do this workout, it's gonna be a lot easier.
Not gonna barf, yeah.
Because I pushed myself through that barrier, my body remembers that. Everyone is different. This is where you have to figure out what works for you.
Uh-huh.
I typically prefer to lift and then go run. And I know people that do it the other way around, but I just feel like if I lift before I go run, I have a better workout. It's done together. My coaches are in communication with each other to know, like, I'm not gonna tax this system out if she's going out there and working that system that day. They have to work together and not against each other. When I work out on the track, you're almost never gonna get a good lift out of me after.
Everyone, if they're competing in some way, is probably gonna end up sprinting. Whether they're a cyclist or a runner, there's always a sprint at the end of the race. So I guess it would just be like, do you take a fraction of your what your total race is and you say like, let's take, you know, like what is your average sprint? Like my sprint lasts like 15 to 30 seconds.
Yeah.
So would you work with that section?
I think I would work with that section or maybe even a little shorter. You want to get yourself up to as many RPMs as you can.
Mm-hmm.
So I would probably go even shorter than what your sprint would last.
Got it.
So if you're saying 15, 20 seconds, I would maybe do 7 to 10 seconds.
Ah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Of just like, just busting it out. All out power. Yeah.
And be willing to barf every once in a while.
Every once in a while it happens. It's okay. Just make sure you hydrate after.
So recovery after your sprint workouts. Do you feel like that's just as important as your workout?
This might just be the athlete in me, the lazy in me. I don't know. I think recovery is even more important than what you're doing out there.
Mm.
Because you have to give your body the time to regenerate. And if you don't, you're gonna run into injury. You're just putting yourself even more at a deficit. So you'll never really truly get to see what you can truly do if you don't allow yourself to recover.
Yeah.
I mean, I was injury prone probably through my sophomore year of college. And then I learned the art of recovery and being proactive, like not waiting for something to happen before you go to seek treatment. It might be expensive to see a chiropractor or a massage therapist weekly, but roll
out,
stretch, like all of those things
lend
to recovery and taking care of your body. It's so important. I can't stress it enough.
Do you have like your 30-minute window you get some protein and creatine and glutamine, or like what is your post-workout jam?
I typically only do protein. The creatine is more dependent on the type of workout that I did. I have a thing with creatine because I have this thing where I can just look at the weights and I put on bulk.
Really?
Yeah, like I just have a propensity to just put on muscle mass. So it's something that I have to be very careful with because, you know, the notion, oh, but it's muscle, then it's like, but I still have to carry it.
Yes.
You know? So that is a fine line for me. But yes, 30 minutes, I'm making sure that I get in protein. I've even started bringing snacks to practice because even the sugar is important, the carbohydrates. I'll bring yogurt and kind of get that down as well. And then, this is a luxury I know, but I go home and take a nap.
Yes. I mean, it is a luxury, and it's also possible to structure your lifestyle that way. I mean, I used to get up and ride really early in the morning and then nap after and then go to work. There's ways.
Yeah. The Spanish have it right. Siesta.
Siesta.
They do. But yeah, and even sleep at night. And if you know that you have a tough workout coming the next morning, make sure you get the proper rest and eat a proper dinner and breakfast before.
How many hours of sleep do you get?
Alright, I'm supposed to say that I get about 6 to 8.
Even if you're not a pro athlete, guys, the winter time can be considered your off season, right? Because you say, like, if you're training for aesthetics or whatever, then summer is when all the clothes come off, and your off season is now. So now's the time for you to get experimental with your diet, crazy with your workouts, you know, like, try some new things, see if you become more powerful, see if your body responds to certain workouts better. Those 2 a days.
But that's where, what you were talking about earlier, the type of athlete that you are, that's where actually keeping track of everything is key, because how will you know
if it works or not?
Affect you if you're not keeping track of it.
Very good point.
Yeah.
But these days there's so many fitness wearables out there and a million ways to track. I track all my movement stuff on Strava. I don't know, I need to get better about writing down the food I eat. Well, now you guys got like a whole toolbox of tips.
Hopefully I was enlightening.
Yes, wait, before we go though.
Uh-oh.
I got 2 colors of lipstick.
Hey, yes! I didn't even wear red lipstick today.
I need you to pick which one's gonna be better for me because I picked 2 out.
Girl, you came ready. Everyone's favorite. I think this one, is this Nikki's? Whose is this?
I'm using this as a mirror. I don't know how that's gonna work out. Ooh, that's bright.
Yes.
So the next time we collab, will you dress me as well? Because I need some fashion.
Girl, you obviously did just by dressing yourself. I'm here for it.
Under Armour, baby. All right.
It's been wonderful. Thank you.
Wonderful talking to you. And she has a channel as well, Natasha Hastings. Go check it out. It is linked below. Click on it. Click subscribe and support female athletes doing badass. Subscribe.
Wait,